I think one of the natural things about NASCAR is it's an engineering sport. A lot of times engineers are sitting behind a desk in a cubicle. In NASCAR, we get to see how fast our cars go versus other people's. It's on computers, it's running simulations, figuring out when the best time to pit is under green flag conditions, trying to find every little thousandth of an inch to make the race car go faster. It's kind of a race of the minds, you could say. I'm J.R. Houston, and I'm a race engineer for 2311 Racing. I gotta remember staring at the camera. I did like a Fox interview or something, and she was like, stop looking away. So I was born in Miami, Florida. My mom was a Cuban immigrant. My dad was from Ohio. And we were watching a lot of motorsports all the time. So when I was 8 years old, my dad bought me my first go-kart. Just a yard cart, you drive around the yard and it would break. I'd flip it over and we'd try and fix the bent part. That was kind of my first introduction to using a wrench. In those early stages of middle school, it was like, what can I do to be involved in NASCAR specifically? I had no idea if it was gonna be a driver, if it was gonna be an engineer. At that point, I just wanted to be involved. So we bought a go-kart and we went go-kart racing. We were racing on weekends, kind of taking my Fridays off. And so a lot of times that meant missing school and, you know, having to take a test early or take a test after everybody else. It became pretty apparent, you know, as we're traveling to these national series races around the Southeast, that the budgets of some people to go win races was just way higher than what we had. And, you know, it was spend all this money and be a race car driver or go to college and get an education and learn about, you know, the sciences behind it. Because at the end of the day, there's maybe 40 to 80 people in the entire United States that get to be a driver. And there's a lot more engineers and people in science that are involved in the sport than that. Space shuttle's taking off over there. Inevitably, that led me to find schools that were engineering-based and ended up going to UNC Charlotte, where I found out they had a motorsports program in engineering. By the junior, senior year of the curriculum, you know, you're really learning more about cars and the physics behind them, you know, taking vehicle dynamics classes, learning about tires and learning about how to collect data off the cars, and after school going and working on the FSAE program and helping out there, whether it was notching tubes and building the race car or actually going out and testing it. Yeah, our Formula SAE team was quite small. We're competing against some of these really huge schools, 50, 100 people, and that kind of really drew me into kind of being the underdog and what can we do as a small team to really compete against these guys and go win. I really wanted to get involved with, you know, a race team, so I went to Darlington, wore my Formula SAE racing polo. It was bright green and just kind of walking around the garage, asking anybody that looked somewhat important, you know, what I needed to do to be an engineer. And I was approached by a guy in a Roush racing polo, and he asked me if I was on the Formula SAE team, and he introduced himself as Joey Cohen to me. And little did I know that wearing that bright green polo to the racetrack was pretty much going to jumpstart my racing career. Late that offseason, Joey contacted me and said he might have an opportunity for me to get my feet wet in the sport. Had an internship at GMS Racing on their part-time Xfinity team that they were starting up. They really wanted to downsize kind of the engineering squad going to the racetrack. So what that meant was I was going to have to, you know, do tire duties and be a mechanic on the side, which wasn't really something that I wanted to do. I kind of told myself I spent 4 years to get this degree. I didn't want to use it to be a mechanic. I really wanted to be an engineer. So kind of took a little bit of a leap of faith there and decided to leave that team. I ended up getting a call one day at lunch, and it was a crew chief with Levine Family Racing, LFR. And they were like, hey, we're looking for somebody to fill in a spot. We have an engineer leaving. And at the time I was like, I don't want to go cup racing. That's so many weekends of the year. So I said I wasn't interested, and I hung up. And I think the next day I called back and I was like,
is that still open?
So I got from December of the previous year kind of taking that leap and going, I don't want to be a mechanic, to 7 months later being an engineer in the Cup Series. Late in the 2020 season, we were informed that LFR would be closing their doors. 2311 was formed. Our crew chief at the time, Mike Wheeler, decided to bring a lot of his engineers and a lot of the people that were working at LFR with him, myself included. I kind of fell into a kind of a creative thinking role to help make better decisions on race day. Once I started cup racing, my dad really wanted to go to a lot of the races. And, you know, we used to drive around the Southeast racing go-karts. Now he doesn't have to pull the trailer and he just goes to the track and gets to see me do my thing, so. I met Ryan, my husband, in 2018, but I wasn't out at the time, and it wasn't really until LFR decided it was gonna shut down to just kind of be myself and come out with my relationship. A lot of people see me and my husband and in the sport, and they don't think that people like us can be involved. And 2311. It was the new team that is inclusive and diverse and kind of breaking the stereotype of a lot of things NASCAR has to offer, right? Really, really, really proud of the team for doing that and looking forward to what there is in the future for the sport. A lot of people don't realize how far the sport has come. It's very innovative, and we spend 40, 50, 60 hours a week trying to make a race car go fast. The sport is graduating into this new era of technology, and engineers now are getting hired left and right because their teams are realizing it's not necessarily just the mechanics that are making race cars go fast, it's also the engineers, you know, making decisions, setting up the cars. And people think that engineering is very math oriented, and there's so much more to it, and you have to be creative and you have to think outside the box, and that's a huge part of our sport, and I think that's a huge part of engineering and science as a whole. You really got to be creative with it. My dad goes to probably 20-ish, 15 to 20 races a year. Anything that's in... Incredible.